Welcome to another video here about the solar eclipse that is going to occur around in about the 25th of October. That you could say when you're watching this in September, you could say that is still a long time. It is, but eclipses, some people say, or some astrologers say, you feel it a month before it, you feel it even 2 months before it, some even say 6 months before it, 6 months after. Anyway, out of experience, I would say a month before, a month after. And this is going to be a very important eclipse, and I want to explain it because a lot of people will already feel now the energies. So what an interesting eclipse this is. It is a solar one. So what does that mean? It means that the sun and the moon are going to be together round in about 2 degrees of Scorpio. And guess what? Venus is going to be there as well. So it's going to be the sun, the moon, and Venus all at 2 degrees of Scorpio. The south node will also be next to it on 13 degrees of Scorpio. So a little bit further away. Therefore, it is called a partial eclipse, not a total. But anyway, so this video is all about what does it mean, and also for the 12 signs in particular, very, very short, concise about explanation about the energy of what can you expect, of course, in general. And see those videos with the monthly videos, then you can see it a little bit more into the bigger picture. Now, first of all, we have to break down what kind of eclipse does this eclipse belong to? And it belongs to the Saturn cycle 6 south. And that is a cycle that was initially also conjunct Venus. So there is definitely a theme here of Venus, which is relationships, value, money, finances, all the beautiful things in life, the things that we enjoy in this life. So definitely a theme here about Venus. Although this is in Scorpio, which is the Pluto-Mars-oriented energy, this is also about Venus. Now, the Saturn cycle 6 south, what is the meaning of that, the interpretation of that? The meaning is actually of a very much focus on relationships, because the Venus was on the initial eclipse, the Venus was there also very close to it. So relationships, and also on the power and the strength, and you could also say on a negative way, the manipulation and the power games that are connected to relationships. So there is a theme there that has to do with that. And last but not least, there's also a Uranian theme. The initial eclipse, the Saturn cycle, where it belongs to the 6th south, and that is the suddenness of these energies around relationships. So like a sudden stop of falling in love, or the sudden initiation and beginning of a falling in love, or a sudden, you could say, a sudden sexual contact. That's also very Venus Uranus like. So these are the themes in general, at the top level, you could say, of this whole cycle of the Saturn cycle of all these eclipses. So keep that in mind when you go towards your specific piece of information that has to do with your sign. Okay, now let's have a look at what is going on now. So this is in Scorpio with the south node. So we know that it's about relationships with the Venus, it's about power, it's about sudden events considering relationships, and it is also, when it is in Scorpio, in a nutshell, it's about also those things like power struggles, toxicity, unhealthy relationships versus a healthy relationship, which is when you stand above it, when you have transformed. That is, you could say, the more elevated side of Scorpio. Scorpio, I know that a lot of people don't like Scorpio. And yes, I think like people who've got Scorpio energy in their chart, they are destined to elevate these very strong desires, because Scorpio is ruled by Mars. So this always gives people a very strong desire nature. And we think, oh, desire, that is a positive vibration. It's not. If you look at the scale of consciousness, desire is just above, I think, above fear. So it's not that high in vibration. And it has to do with because you don't have it yet. And you are desiring, well, whatever it is, and you are desiring to getting it. And often in a way, when you are too attached to what you want, it's actually pushing the things further away. People who've got Scorpio planets understand everything about this. They don't need an explanation here. They are learning to stand above their desires, which is the, you could say, the eagle, right? The ego has desires and it uses it as a path, as a vision, as you could say, a direction. But it trusts. That's the whole thing about Scorpio, trust issues, right? But when it stands above that and it trusts the universe and themselves, the strength that it brings up is like, okay, when I long for something and it doesn't come, I trust that the universe knows best. So it's in a certain belief in something that is bigger than you. You know, you are not God, but an element of the God's creation, you could say, or nature creation or universe creation, whatever you want to call it. That is the whole thing here. So we've got a team here of healthiness versus unhealthiness, of toxicity because of the strong desire, which is like, you know, in the tarot, it's represented by the devil, right? You are like having strong desires, but you are so attached that you are like a slave almost, whatever it is that you're desiring. And it is versus, you could say, the magician. I don't know a lot about tarot, by the way, but it's, I know that a lot of people who see these horoscopes also watch tarot. And I think that there are a lot of things that can be explained by that. So the magician is more like, I've got these tools here and I'm going to use them, but I really have the ability to do so, to do healthy stuff, right? Which is like, yes, I like something or someone, but hey, if it's not happening, I'm okay with the universe. I am in line with the divine, and that gives the highest form of Scorpio. So don't always think that Scorpio is bad and like Gemini is good, for instance. It doesn't work that way. Every sign has a pro side and a contra side. It has a positive side and a negative side, but it is in itself neutral energy. So it's up to us whether we are going to elevate that energy or not. And therefore, this can be a very tough eclipse, because Scorpio is a tough sign. It's not an easy sign. The modern ruler is Pluto. It's supposed to be the most difficult planet to handle. And Pluto is all about power. Look in the world, right? When power is given to you in a certain way, whether it is for you, whether you have power in a financial way, you are maybe a man and you have a lot of money, you have power there. Maybe you are a woman and you have great beauty. That is your sexual power, can also be power. Maybe you have a power of knowledge, whatever it is, you can misuse it. And that's the whole thing of this Scorpio eclipse, to step aside from toxicity and to go towards elevating towards the real good stuff of Scorpio, which is strength, which is empowerment, which is, you can do so much to transform your life. So we've got a lot of this intense energy. It's a super intense eclipse, but it's a south node eclipse. So it's a double whammy here. Scorpio is all about the death and the rebirth. It's all about letting go of something that is no longer serving you, no longer authentic towards something that is more real for you. But the, you could say, the universe decides whether this is good for you or not. It's not, of course, when you are intuitive, you know, but all people have the intuition that is strongly developed. So but it will definitely be a wake-up call for many of us. And the South Node is about the letting go. It's about karmic energy. It's about, yes, this was your karma, but now the cycle is ended and you need to let go of it. So this is a new moon in itself. The third triple whammy, you could say, is also about ending a new beginning. So we have an enormous, of course, you could say every day we end and every new day we start anew. That is true. But this is more intense and has to do with every single person doing its own growth process. And growth only happens by saying goodbye to something old and stepping into the unknown. And that is what this eclipse is all about. We are all going to shed off the skin of the snake, you could say, and in order for us to be reborn. But a lot of people like that story of the phoenix, you know, that rises out of the ashes. And this is symbolism for sure for this South Node eclipse, solar eclipse. But a lot of people tend to forget that first there needs to be figuratively a dying of something. And that is the most difficult, because if you have Scorpio planets or a strong Pluto in your chart, you will know that saying goodbye to something that you're really attached to is very, very hard. You know, look at addictions, look at, you know, again, the devil card in the tarot. It's a lot about that. And when you can turn that card around, it is like you managed, you mastered your own shadow, so to speak. It's a lot about that. I think it's one of the most important eclipses of this year, because if we do this right, if we say goodbye to something that is no longer serving us and we're not resisting it, because this is, you will resist death in a way. It's like you're carrying it along with you, whether this is a relationship, whether it is a job, whether it is something, a project, a wish that you are holding on to words too strongly, whatever it is, it's good to let go. This is a time of surrendering, but in a good way. You know, I don't really like, I have Venus in Scorpio and my ruler in Scorpio, so I don't like the word surrendering, but sometimes we need to. And we all know it when we are so strongly attached to something, but we know that it's not for our own good. It's a lot about this energy. And so this is, I'm looking at May 2022. Veerle, that is not good. That is not good. There you go. Yes, let it. So this is all about letting go. I'm just repeating because I don't want to skip anything here. Yes, intense, ruled by Mars, ruled by Pluto, but we've got the Venus planet here as well that is playing such a big role. So this is all about relationships. And it's going away from the drama of the negative Scorpio energy, right? Crisis, drama, fear, value of others. No, it's not where we need to go to. I mean, value of others, wanting the value of others. You know, someone with Venus-Pluto energy, for instance, or Venus and Scorpio energy, they kind of, when they want something, they kind of, how would I say, they morph themselves into something that they are not in order to, they manipulate in order to receive the validation of that other person. And it has to do with power. So that you do have power there, that you do have that man on your knees, or that you do have that job and you walk all over other people who are your competitors or whatever. It is, you know, it's that darkness, it's that energy. And again, that's the negative side of all this Scorpionic Plutonic energy. It's manipulation, it's seduction, it's the intention is not pure. But when, and of course, what goes around comes around. And oh, this is quantum physics. When you're sending out that energy, you're going to get maybe a good result in the short term, but in the long term, it comes back. You know, energy is never wasted. And, or it transforms. Or what is it? You know, E is MC quadrat. I don't know the quadrat. How do you say that in English? Anyway, I'm digressing here. You see, I don't know a lot about physics, but I try to understand it. But anyway, the thing is that the good side, we want the good side of Scorpio, which is strength, which is we learn from our mistakes. It humbles us that if we know that there is something bigger that we are an element of and that knows best with us, you know, when we go with nature, when we go with the divine, so to speak, we can do so much, and we become the magicians rather than, you know, being there, the devil card all over us. So interesting eclipse. Of course, if you've got planets in Scorpio, in Taurus, in Aquarius, or in Leo, around and about 2 degrees, you will feel this enormously. And it's all about stepping away from this Scorpionic side on the negative side. And it's going towards, of course, Taurus, which is about your value, which is about self-love, which is filling up your own cup and not filling up a cup of by someone else, because that cup will always be empty, right? So it's a lot about strengthening the soul. And yeah, strengthening the soul. I like that. Don't forget that we are in the midst of an atmosphere of Mars square Neptune, which is also very manipulative energy, and Mercury square Pluto around the timing of the eclipse. Mercury is going to square Pluto. So we will want to know the root of the matter. Information, hidden information will come up and can play a role here in that transformation that is surely going to happen with this solar eclipse. So what an eclipse this is. Let's break it down for the separate signs. Aries people, this is happening in your eighth house. Well, this is the deep house. This is the Scorpio house. And this actually is all about the death and the rebirth on a level of, first of all, finances. So there could be that you have to take a distance when it comes to when you are in a relationship, for instance, when it comes to the resources of your partner. So there could be a death and a rebirth, you know, a little crisis, hopefully not too big, but ultimately it's to strengthen it. It's to empower it. It's to make it stronger. You know, this Scorpionic energy is all about, it breaks down something that is no longer suiting you. On another level, this could mean that, so it could mean that your spouse, for instance, is going through a transformation when it comes to their money, and that has a knock-on effect on you. But because of Venus, it's next to Venus, right? So it's about relationships as well. And Venus rules in your chart the seventh house of relationships and the second house of money. So it's really, for a lot of you, this has to do with how you look at investments, or there is a cycle closing. It could mean also that a debt is closed, right? Your loan is, you know, it was for 10 years and it's the last time that you have to pay. Can be something like that as well. That is a positive thing, of course. Whether this is positive or negative, it depends on your individual chart, of course. But let's try to focus on the positive, okay? So that you can improve. The real deal here is to improve your financial situation that you share with other people, or insurances, or investments. And another thing here is intimacy. So with Venus, it could mean here, with all the Scorpionic energy, you know, of course, this is no judgment here, but the eighth house is a very hidden house. So things could come to an end when there is hidden stuff going on for you on a relationship level. And when that happens, it needs to be like that so that you can start anew with a lot more confidence for the self and respect for the self. You know, it's like the typical story of playing the second violin in a relationship, that you are saying, nah, my self-worth here is, I'm respecting myself way more, so I want to be number one, not the second violin. For instance, and for others, this could be in an existing relationship, a deepening of intimacy. And a deepening of intimacy because there is more vulnerability. So there is a pattern there that could have been done now in a new way. And that opens up a lot more, not only sexuality is a part of intimacy, but it can improve that. by being vulnerable also on a soul level way, so to speak. Taurus people, very important eclipse for you, especially if you have planets around 2 degrees. This is happening in your seventh house. So something is happening, whether you are single or not, with another person. Even when you are single, there's someone there that is catching your eye for sure. And either they are going through some major transformation in their life for whatever reason. Maybe that it has to do with work, it has to do with whatever it has to do with. But they are going through a major change, and the North Node is in your first house. So it's all about you getting back to you. So it depends on your story. If you have given away your power, like you did the 80% in a relationship, they did 20, this is not going to work anymore. And that's a good thing, of course. It's a painful thing, ending of a relationship. But again, this is not something new. You know, I don't want to scare you here. You know, you don't have, if you're having a great relationship at the moment, you don't have to say, Veerle said in the video. No, it doesn't work that way. You know your story. If you're having not a good relationship, if you're like, there are so many more minuses than pluses in the relationship, yes, this could be indeed an end. And it's karmic, like the universe saying to you, you ended this and you have lived out the karma thing and you can go on and focus on you again. In when you are single, for instance, this could be even a start of a very karmic, intense relationship. Because the Venus there is connected to it. And are you going to, together with that other person, transform because of the connection both of you have? So the ruler of Venus is you, and also your sixth house. So your day-to-day life is also about to change because of this relationship stuff is going on here. So whatever it is for you, the universe is really like giving you this mirror, that's for sure. It's the seventh house is your relationship house, but it's working like a mirror, right? You are seeing what you have, what you have put into the relationship. So it's instead of when the relationship is bad and you want to end it and all of that, instead of putting the blame on someone else, you just work on yourself. You just work on your new exploration of you, basically, and that can help you. As I said, for others, when they are in a relationship, it's definitely a turning point here. Something could come out that has to do with secrets, and but that can be for better or for worse. Mostly, of course, it's for worse, but we don't have, every single story is different. But because of that, it's been put on the table. And with the Mercury square Pluto, you will not want to hide this. You will want to know the bottom of this, and you're gonna do that, and that can clear it. And it's up to you and that other person whether you are going to continue on a new slate or not. You know, you've got that choice there. So very interesting for you, dear Taurians, and a lot of clarity will come from this for sure. Geminis, for you, this is not the most important solar eclipse, as this is happening in your sixth house. Though your sixth house is a house of your day-to-day work, it's a house of your health. So there could be some endings and new beginnings there. There could be also, when it comes to what you love at the workplace or when it comes to your work, some sort of a shift there. Could mean an ending of a job because you don't like to do it. And now it gives you that energy to stop it and to go for a new one, for instance. But you can do this in a very strategic way, because Scorpio is the strategy here, you could say. On another level, this has to do with some new ways of doing your work. So the old way that you were doing it was a bit unhealthy, you know, whatever you understand around that. And now you are wanting to start on a new slate with more energy and with more authenticity, so to speak. Also for your health, there could be some really releasements here, especially with the Venus there, releasing of some you could say things that were holding you back because of your health. And now because of that Scorpio, it's like this whole transformation that is going on for you. It makes me think of like an ayahuasca kind of thing that you could be doing, or that is more on a mental level, so to speak. But it could be something that is quite intense, you know, like a total breakdown and a rebuilding up of something that has to do with your health. But for those of you who are really struggling with a health issue, this can be just it to see that turning point. And that is a good thing. Cancerians, for you, this is rather a positive eclipse. Why? Because Scorpio is a water sign and you are a water sign. But of course, it's in your fifth house, the house of love and the house of the heart chakra. So this is about the house, what you love. And it represents your children, if you have them. It represents love, right? The love stories that are happening in your life. It also considers your projects, the things that you want to do. Maybe you want to start your own business. That's a project. That's your own creativity. That is the fifth house as well, and everything that has to do with what you love to do, that's the fifth house. So there is some sort of a dying here, figuratively, of all these things. So there could be something happening in, if you have a child, in the area of life of your child, that they're going through a transformation. And mostly, you know, this is a good thing, because again, this goes in good energy with your energy. And it could be simply that your child is going through a totally new phase, and it has a knock-on effect on you, because you need to let go of how your child was before. Maybe they're going out for college. Maybe they just have their first romance in their life. You know, all these kind of things can have an effect on you as well. On the level of love, this can definitely mean an ending of a love, and but in a strange way, although this is something that you might hold on to very strongly, you are ready now to release it. So if you have had some love story going on that has really gripped, taking you know, it's like a bit under your skin energy, then this is the release, and that can be a good thing. On another level, maybe you are single, this can be a new love story for sure. A new love coming into your life that is quite, you know, as it said in the Sado cycle, that can be quite sudden, a sudden falling in love, a sudden sexual contact. The suddenness is here for sure. And it can be something that is life transforming. Because of that connection, it changes your whole life. And so definitely, and also for your projects, or there could be an old project that you are finishing up, or it could also mean that the old way, how you do your hobbies, how you do pleasure, you're gonna say goodbye to that, especially when it's toxic and not healthy, and you're gonna do some other things that really point you towards people that are like-minded, because the North Node is in your 11th house of friends, 11th house of also associations, like-minded people. So to focus a little bit more on that. Leos, very important if you are Leo, having planets around 2 degrees of Leo. This is happening in the core of your chart. Very important. This is an eclipse in the house, literally of your house. So you could be literally selling and buying. Some of you could really do that, and it's like a very karmic cycle. So some of you, excuse me, could really move to another country even, you know, it has that kind of karmic, scorpionic energy to it. For others, this has to do more on an emotional level, and that is very deep. So people will not see this and will not know this, because the fourth house is a very hidden house as well. It's your hidden treasure, so to speak. And it has to do, it can have to do also with a parent, a connection with a parent. A parent is going through a transformation stage and it has an effect on you, or the cycle with a parent is drastically changing. I mean, the connection, whatever it is very karmic, it's very meant to be energy. And I would say don't fight it, right? Whatever it is. And also this emotional stuff. So the old way that you are doing emotions, that whether it is you are being very reactive or whether it is you're being very passive when something happens, it is time to transform this. It is time to not do this anymore and to go towards a more healthy emotional state. And that is, you receive that through the work and the process of old patterns that you're not doing anymore. It has to do with survival mechanisms. So we do things to survive on different levels. You know, one person fights, another person flights, right? So, and it's about these patterns that you can, it's a very psychological thing here, because you can understand yourself better. When you understand yourself better, your life becomes better. At least you have that knowledge and you can work from there. And you will understand others because of that as well. So, Virgos, this is in your third house. This is not the most bad in, or difficult or whatever scorpionic solar eclipse for you. But the third house is a very mercurial house. So I think this is something that you will understand, that something around your thinking patterns, around the way that you communicate. Also, the third house is siblings, is the people in a neighborhood, it's short trips. There is a death and a rebirth there going on. So for some of us who are having your own business, for instance, could simply mean shutting down an old website and making a new one because it was not working for you. It was really, really giving you nightmares, so to speak, and you're starting off a new one. But that first one needs to go down. Also, your relationship with siblings and with people around you could drastically change here, because something in their lives is going on that has a knock-on effect on you. So they are going through a transformation, or there is something that changes the relationship again, for better or for worse. How it is now, let's say now it would be a very bad relationship that you have with a sibling. Something occurs all of a sudden and there is a restoration here. So, but for most of you, this is vehicles are also the third house. So you could be literally letting go of an old vehicle and a new one. This is actually the case for me. I'm a Virgo. So you see how accurate these things are. It's amazing. Anyway, otherwise I wouldn't do it. The astrology, I mean. So it could also mean learning processes. So something that you've learned, it's karmic, you stopped and you go for something new. So for those of you who were at school or being a student, there could be here some wrapping up, and so that you can go forwards with your life in a more authentic way. Also, communication, yes. So definitely something could, because it's with Venus, something could come out that was hidden for you because of the scorpionic energy here. And that changes a lot, your connections with people in your neighborhood, people that you see on a daily basis, siblings, but also your thoughts in general. There could be something that you've learned here very deeply. Because remember, your ruler is Mercury is squaring up to Pluto at the same time. You're going through a transformation because maybe information is coming to you or you are saying something. But I think it will rather come to you here. So, Librans, this is happening in your second house. Not the most important solar eclipse for you, but it's all about self-worth and finances. So, let's start with finances. This could be for some of you who are going through struggles when it comes financially. This could be the deepest point, the lowest point. And before you are going towards the building up again. And because this is a death and a rebirth, remember? So you can find out some things that were not working for you, financial structures that were not working for you, maybe losses or whatever. Now, if you're saying like, ooh, this energy, I want to apply it at its best, I would recommend you strongly to give away things that are no longer suiting you, because then you are trying to use this energy yourself at its best. Scorpio is about ending. The South Node is about ending. I remember when I was having this eclipse in my second house, and with many of clients that I always advise them to like give away or sell or whatever, their old books, their old belongings, old clothes, books that you're not reading anymore, furniture that you dislike and that is not working for you anymore. It's passé, passé composé. So give it away, sell it, and it's gonna make place for new stuff that is way more suiting you, way more better of quality. And so in that respect, it's really a cleaning up for you. On another level, this has to do with your self-worth. You could be at a very low level when it comes to your self-worth at the moment, but you must reach first the lowest level to go towards, you know, the upgrade that you're having. And it has to do with toxicity in relationships, because Venus is, of course, you. And but also with the eighth house, it's also with the validation of others. So if it's the case for you that you are giving like 80% and that other person 20, you know, it's about, this eclipse is all about the old way that you saw yourself. The that is just dying, so to speak. So yeah, get ready for some new energy coming for you that is going to restore your self-worth. Scorpios, dear Scorpio, Scorpio, Scorpio. People who've got a sun, moon, ascendant in Scorpio, or like me, like a Venus in Scorpio, or my ruler in Scorpio, or maybe you have your Mars in Scorpio. People who've got planets between 0 and, you could say, 8 degrees of Scorpio, you will feel it the most. Of course, every Scorpio will feel it, because this is a solar eclipse. It's about all that I said in the beginning is applicable for you. And I remember when the solar eclipse was in my sign, in my ascendant sign, it was, you know, it's one of the best things, because it's like a dying of the old you. And it's never nice. It's never easy to say goodbye to old parts of you, because it's something that you have invested in so much. That was Scorpio. Usually Scorpios do invest. That's why they are called such a passionate sign, because they invested not 100% at all. No, 1000%. And then they have to say goodbye to that. That's not easy. And but you will know that parts of you need to go. Whether it is a part, like for instance, you're maybe you are pregnant. And you have to say goodbye to an old lifestyle, right? You will get up in the morning at 6 o'clock sometimes. You really will. And to not resist that and to surrender to that new you that is waiting for you. That is more you, more suiting you, more in line with the divine, etc., etc. So whatever it is, or it is a job that someone needs to let go of, and or even a career, maybe you are a nurse and you are fancying a career as a, I don't know, a maker of jewelry, I don't know, I'm just inventing here, sur place. And yes, you will have to say goodbye to the old you. It's always with a little bit of, you know, tearing up, so to speak. But anyway, you know why you're doing it, and you're going towards something that is even better for you. That is the energy. So welcome this energy is basically what I'm trying to say here, and you're going to transform. It's one of those moments, dear Scorpios, it is. Especially also in love. So when it comes to love, there is also something that is very destined here. You've got the North Node in your seventh house. You're meeting new people, whether you are in a relationship or not. You are meeting new people. Some new people are very important for you for your future. And that can be like, oh, it hurts, because then if I want to go with those people, if I want to align myself, I have to, some old parts of me, I have to say goodbye of them. Maybe you used to be someone who was very lazy and who's not working at all. And all of a sudden you're in love with someone, you have a relationship with someone who's working very hard and who's doing their best, who wants to get somewhere in life and who wants to, achieve some personal goals. And that person draws you with them, but you have to say goodbye to that lazy man or woman there. I exaggerate here a little bit in the black and white, but it's to make you understand that it's not always a bad thing having the South Node in your sign. It's actually a time of metamorphism, you could say. And I was just getting a message here that also that has to do with an ending and a new beginning. So this is really truly for you applicable. And yes, some of you Scorpios will attract, because you are changing, and because of that you're going to attract new people. It's very simple. And some of the people that you are very close to, you will have to say goodbye to them in a way. Of course, don't panic here. You know it already. This is a process. This is not, although there is an energy here of the all of a sudden. So yes, all of a sudden you could realize I don't love someone anymore. Or all of a sudden you could realize I do love someone very strongly. You know, it's that sudden energy that I was talking about in the beginning, or falling in love very deeply. You could say first and foremost with self. Not in a narcissistic way too much, but in a way of, yeah, I'm worth it. I'm worth for love. And maybe that is the accelerator to say goodbye to an old relationship. So some of you are going to end a relationship for sure. But it's a lot about, because you have changed so much. And if you understand that, you're doing right to you and also to that other person. So yes, very deep here. I could go on and on, you see. It also rules the 12th house. So things really are coming out here, and you want to that new seed planting of your new life, and therefore also new connections. Sagittarians, this is all happening behind the scenes. You are having this in your 12th house, just the house before, or the sign before your sign. And this is actually not really the most important eclipse, but it all has to do with a release, I think. And that's a good, I see it more in a good way, because it's Venus and it's with the scorpionic energy. It's a release of something. It could be with Venus in the 12th house that, let's say, you have had for a long time, you've been in love in secret, or you have an eye for someone who's just not available. That's Venus in the 12th house. And because of events that will have take place in a sudden way, you kind of can let go of that, you know, that longing. It's a very scorpionic longing kind of energy here, if you have that in your 12th house. Or it could mean that when you had, for instance, a secret relationship, that it could end, or it could start one as well, to be honest. I'm saying this without judgment at all, but it's just the energy here. And of course, you can ask yourself, is this what you want? All this secretive energy, because it's going to demand a lot of your energy to keep that secret. But the thing is, with all this energy in your 12th house, you can keep it secret. But of course, it will have consequences as well. I'm not here to tell you that. But on another level, if you say, Veerle, all that drama that you're talking about here, in a good way, this could mean a toxic behavior that you had in the past, maybe having a secret relationship, or maybe having some sort of an addiction, whatever it is, that you're saying goodbye to. And you say, oh, I've been struggling with that for years. Sometimes you do see it. It's quite uncommon, but that people are struggling so long with an addiction, whatever it is, that addiction. But all of a sudden they're ready. it's like, and then it happens, you know. That could also be that Venus with that Uranian flavor from the initial solar initial eclipse there. It could mean that you're ready now, and it's not just because you're ready now, it's because you've done all that work before. It's like karma. What comes around goes around. It's the cycle has closed. So I hope for a lot of you, a lot of people who are struggling with addictions, that can end here, an addiction, and that it is a freeing up for sure. It's a painful one though, because it's always, you know, Scorpio, but it's definitely going through that pain and the healing. There's a lot of healing here with this energy in the 12th house. Some of you could also enjoy of investigating. You know, this is a Sherlock Holmes in, energy. This is if you are like working for your PhD, you're gonna love it. You're gonna love this time where you have to do some really deep digging into deep you know, information that is hard to find and that you have to dig deep. It's like an archaeologist, so to speak. It's that kind of energy. Also, old patterns of yourself that you could release here that are a bit toxic or that are no longer suiting you. Very interesting. Capricorns, this is happening in your 11th house, not the biggest deal. And Scorpio goes well with Capricorn. It's a sextile, but it's happening in your 11th house. Two big teams here, the 11th house friends, and also your goals and wishes for the future. So let's start with the goals and the wishes for the future. It's the future house. So it could mean that a couple of your dreams that you had, they need to go. It was toxic. It was taking too much of your time energetically, and you're not going forwards. You need to let go of that. Or a certain hope that you had for something to achieve in the future, you say, I'm releasing it. And it's going to give you a lot of new energy if you do that. And so it can take place, give place for other new goals for the future, for sure. Throughout, you know, the end of the year, you could really start with a whole new kind of more authentic goal for the future. So that's interesting. On another level, this is about friendships or a friendship. There could be a transformation going on here because a friend goes through something very scorpionic and very transformative. So they could go through quite some crises here, and it has a knock-on effect on you as well. Because the relationship is never gonna be the same anymore. So there could be a connection, a friendship connection that is never gonna be the same anymore because Venus is in here. It could mean also, and Scorpio is in here. It could mean also that the relationship changes when it comes to the form. So you have friends and Venus is here, Scorpio is sexuality as well. So you could go from friends to a more romantic side here. And of course, that is going to transform you and them as well. Because then it's not friends anymore. It's like your lover, for instance. So you see that kind of energy. Or something comes out that has to do with secrets. Therefore, you enter a relationship, for instance. Or they end it. You know, it's definitely not business as usual with a certain group of people or with your with a specific friend. Aquarians in your 10th house, very important eclipse for you, especially when you've got planets between 0 and 8 degrees of Aquarius. You will feel it very, very strongly because the south node solar eclipse is in your 10th house. This is all about when you do have a career, it's about your career. If you don't have a career, this could be a parent. So something in the life of a parent is very transformative for that parent and has a knock-on effect on you, or the relationship can shift. It can also mean your social status, from being married to divorce, from being divorced to being in a relationship again, from having no kids towards a position of getting a kid. You know, your social status is also the 10th house. But for most of you, it will be work. It will be your career. There is definitely a dying of something here when it comes to your career. And let it happen, I would say. If you feel that your career is not the same anymore, that you are struggling, that you are forcing something, I would say surrender. And although it might be painful for you because you identified so strongly to that career, it can more gracefully shift towards what is coming new and what is more authentic and more real for you and more fitting you when it comes to your career. Venus is here as well, so it could also mean love with bosses and with people that are significant for your career with the Venus here. But it has that transformative energy. So, which is logical, right? If you have a connection with your boss, for instance, I can imagine that the things are changing in your life and for that person as well. But whatever it is, it's a letting go of a cycle that is closed and you're ready for a new one. And yes, that is like that new cycle is very, very new and it's very fresh and it's very unknown and a bit scary there. But it's the whole point. It's something that suits you better. Then last but not least, Pisces. This is happening in your ninth house. For you Pisces, this is it's still Scorpio, it's still South Node. It's still an eclipse, but it's more lovely for you because you are a water sign. Scorpio is also a water sign. And in the ninth house, this has to do with the dead and a rebirth that has to do with, for instance, travel. So there could be a shift there that you were, that there is a connection. Venus is here as well. That could be a connection from abroad, that there is a transformation. Either, let's say, for instance, you would have a connection with someone from abroad and you would have an internet connection or whatever. And something changes, so you get to know each other now in a real way, so you see each other face to face, and no, it's not there anymore. You know, all of a sudden you're out of love. You know that as it was said in the beginning, all of a sudden changes there in love. But because this energy is fluent with your energy, you're not gonna really not being able to handle this, you see. On another level, this could mean new love approaching you that is very karmic, that has to do with someone from abroad or from a different culture, to say the least. And that is pretty intense, so to speak, and it feels very karmic, you know. It could be that as well. And for others, it's about studies and learning the ending of it or the new beginning of this as well. Also, when you are in the published world, you know, writing a book, you could have it comes to a closure, the ending of writing a book, for instance, or the ending of a website, the ending of a YouTube channel, and you want to start a new one, for instance. It could be something like that as well. It can also mean, because the ninth house has to deal with a connection with the divine, that you feel that your old belief systems are no longer suiting you and you feel it's karmically done there. That can be a very good thing, by the way, especially because Scorpio is about holding on to something too strongly. Therefore, Pisces can, although it is a sign that seems very easygoing, their ninth house is Scorpio, so which is a very stubborn sign. That's why a lot of Pisces can have a very, actually, although it might not seem like that, a very rigid pattern of a belief system. So there's something that needs to go here. An old belief system needs to go for your own good, so to speak. So it could be anything, right? You could say, yeah, I have a belief system that drinking a bottle of whiskey every day is good. Now you're saying, who am I fooling here? Or you could have a belief, it's a bit of a foolish example, isn't it? Let's grab another one. What about a belief system that you had that you didn't believe in, the classical, conservative doctor's world, because of something, right? Or because of your belief, no, it's only the alternative medicine is good. The classical medicine is bad, for instance. That was your belief system. And because of things happening that could relate to love, that could also relate to value of other people, money with, that you share with other people, you kind of realize it's not true. Or because you had an experience with a physical doctor. We're turning towards the end of the video, but I don't want to go down here in the quality. But you know what I mean, a physician. And maybe they are helping you out, and they're helping you out with a problem that was like 10 years already that you were having this problem, and you're saying, ah, I have to restore, I have to get rid of this belief system that all doctors are bad. It's not true. You see that kind of thing. There's something really drastic going on in your belief system. I say drastic because changing a belief system is something drastic. When you are a socialist from when you were born, for instance, you're not going to turn into a liberal all of a sudden. Well, with this energy, it can happen to you. Can really, really happen to you, and it's really interesting, and it's a very positive again, ultimately, because it's in a trine to your energy, so it's going to help you definitely with other parts of your life as well. Having said that, thank you so much for all of you for watching my videos. I'm so grateful for a lot of people watching these videos, sharing them and commenting them and asking for readings and so on. Thank you so much. And all the best to you. See you next time. Bye-bye.